Down Majority Rules.
I heard something in that office. I'm just not sure what it was.
Don't you girls know? City Hall is supposedly haunted by Lord Mayfield's ghost.
Lord Mayfield actually died at City Hall.
We should go check it out.
Yeah, see if he shows.
You have to admit, it'd be the ultimate Halloween event.
Come on, Bex. It could be serious scientific investigation.
This is genius. We'll test the theory, see if ghosts exist.
Yeah. How? There is no ghost, I don't think.
One should not take the spirit world too lightly.
Look, we probably just blew a fuse because of all the equipment.
The EMF detector's off the charts.
Chopin! And that's Sonata number 2. Funeral march.
No one die until I get back.
It looks like there was a struggle.
Look, the camcorder.
Quick, check the footage.
No.
Where's Mom?
Where are you?
Okay, let's stay calm. Okay, Mo's missing, but there's probably a rational explanation. We just need to figure it out.
What's to figure out? You saw the tape. Mo went back to get the camera. There was a huge struggle, and then the ghost took him. The ghost of Lord Mayfield.
Okay, that's ridiculous.
Why would he take Mo, Becky's mare? In terms of ghost napping, Becky's way more valuable.
Yeah, but Mo's entertaining. It might be dull in the afterlife.
I hope not. Then our entire existence is just one big disappointment.
Could we maybe focus here? Jarman, what are you thinking?
I don't know. With Mo around, I think in stereo. I'm missing half my brain, dudes.
We could respond to that. That's way too easy.
Well, I'm not buying any of this. Let's see this.
Get away! Back off! Get back! Get away! No.
Whoa. Pause that. Zoom in. Mo's got a cell on him.
Do you think there's service in the spirit world?
One way to find out.
You think it's a hoax, don't you?
Well, of course I do. What else could it be? Mo's probably just sitting there laughing at us.
What?
No. Get away. Back off.
Just a girl who never really thought of fame, in a place where no one even knew my name. So here I go, it's funny how things can change, but I know that I'll be ready for everything anyway. Bring it on, you know I got what it takes. Raise your hands and say,
thanks, Keeks.
Well, sorry, but what do you expect?
Your phone was possessed, Becky. Like the girl in The Exorcist.
You still think it's a hoax? Because I don't. Something weird is going on.
Okay, the security system's still on, right? Doors are locked, which means Mo couldn't have left the building. He has to be here. So let's look for him. And when we find him, I'm gonna wring his neck.
Not if I find him first. Checking the security tape.
Oh, I'll go with you.
Why?
Why do you think? If the ghost does show up, I don't want your combative nature to scare him away.
I thought you said it was important to show the ghost who the boss is.
Yeah, only if the boss is me. Let's go.
Hey, if you need anything, call Kiki's cell. You coming?
Do I have a choice?
These help you see better, right?
Where are you? Mo!
ridiculous and make everything blurry.
Did you turn them on?
Oh. Vanished into thin air.
So, about the ghost you saw at music camp?
She was a little girl, about 10.
Oh, little kids are the scariest. Think of the poltergeist.
It's not a joke, German. She was the daughter of the camp's founder. Music prodigy? Died in the flu epidemic of 1918? Anyways, she was sitting at the end of my bed when I woke up one night.
Did she speak to you?
She told me to take up hockey.
What?
She said my oboe playing was offending her. And she was right. I was so miserable at music camp. What I really wanted was to go to hockey camp. So I called my parents the next day, and the rest was history.
You at hockey camp?
Was a phase.
And you really weren't scared of her?
No, she did me a favor. Of course, not all ghosts are friendly. Anyone in here? Come out, okay? Right now! Oh, too bad, I don't see anyone. Let's go! Ah! Oh, the pipes, remember? What about that other sound? The one we heard before we were stupid enough to come in here? Oh my gosh. Whoa, I wonder what's up there. Are you joking? Are you seriously thinking about climbing those? Oh! Margo's cupcake! Do you think Lord Mayfield was hungry? Somebody else is. Mo? Mo, are you up here? Stop fooling around! Hello?
Hey, Kiki, it's Jack. I tried Becky already, but her cell's not working.
Oh, yeah. Hi, Jack. Yeah, her phone broke.
So how's the ghost busting?
Creepy with a capital C. You won't even believe where we are right now. Some old spiral staircase that leads to some dusty attic room.
Yeah, that's Lord Mayfield's old study. Legend is he died on those stairs. Someone pushed him.
Lord Mayfield was murdered right where we were standing. Jack, hello? Something just touched me. On my leg. I felt it!
Solve this.
We need our strength, Becky. Lord Mayfield has Mo. He's kidnapped him. And he's torturing him with Chopin.
Could be worse. Couldn't be country music.
How could you joke? With Mo covered in ghost goo.
Will you guys just cool it?
You're not still doubting it, are you? That there's a ghost?
Okay. What do we have here as evidence? The stolen cupcake. The image on the security tape. Kiki's feeling at City Hall.
It wasn't a feeling. Something touched me.
And the music. if Lord Mayfield did take Mo, then he took him for a reason. Unfinished business! Yeah, he was murdered. So, we try and contact him. Draw him out.
You mean like a seance?
You've got to be kidding. We do want Mo back. Don't we?
Seance in City Hall, take one.
Join hands, everyone. Wait! In case he's still hungry.
This is stupid.
Becky, lose the attitude.
You really want Lord Mayfield hanging around your office for the next 4 years?
Mm-mm.
We're calling on the spirit of Cratchley Mayfield.
Cratchley?
Well, that's his name. It says so in his biography.
Seance, take two.
We're calling on the spirit of Lord Mayfield.
If you can hear us, please come out.
Remind him we have cupcakes.
Shh. This is so bogus.
Wait. I smell something.
Yeah, right.
No, seriously. It smells like roses.
I smell it too.
Rosewater. Lord Mayfield's favorite scent.
Good arm, Richards.
Oh, I don't believe it!
We are so gonna kill you!
Ooh!
And scene.
Oh. You're in it, all of you, right from the beginning?
That's right, Jack's idea.
Halloween, haunting, it was too good to pass up.
We made a special Chopin tape, Mo had it on him, plus a bunch of other sound effects.
And I had already slipped into the back entrance before Sam locked the doors.
You called us from inside?
Uh-huh. It was just luck that I caught you guys on the spiral staircase.
So Mayfield wasn't murdered?
No. Well, I mean, he did die here, and that was his study, but I made the murder part up.
We got it all on tape. Killer shots of girls screaming their heads off.
It'll be viral on Yahoo.
Happy Halloween, ladies.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't.
Oh, really? Then who did?
Lord Mayfield died on Halloween night. He was working late in his study.
The room above the spiral stairs.
He was writing a document, a bill he'd written, giving permission for musicians to play music at City Hall during working hours. It's very important to him.
That's ironic. Counselor Pugh won't allow anyone to play music now at City Hall.
But he died before he could get it passed. We need to find that document.
What? Why?
Because it could be his unfinished business. What if Becky signed that bill into law? Then Lord Mayfield could rest in peace.
Sweet. We could get the whole thing on film. Blair Witch, but with heart.
Are you people nuts? That document's over 100 years old. I wouldn't even know where to begin looking for it.
I think I do.
I used to play in here all the time when I was a kid.
Brave kid.
They've got files in here dating back to the founding of the Mayfield. Oh, it's just mice, I think.
Oh, right.
Actually, I'm kind of scared of mice. Do you mind?
Not so much.
So are you buying this, really? The whole haunting of City Hall?
Are you?
I don't know. Strange things do happen.
Yeah. You have your arm around me right now. There's a time I would have decked you for that.
And now?
It's not my first thought.
Ah! Oh, Becky.
Are you okay?
Oh, fine. My pride's hurt.
What?
This is it! The build that Lord Mayfield was working on the night he died!
Out of all these files?
I know. It's like he's talking to us from the grave.
Ghostly signing ceremony, take one.
Wait! Your nose is shiny.
So is yours. The ghosts don't care, Keeks.
Well, I do.
Take two.
As Mayor of Mayfield, in honor of Lord Mayfield's final wish, I now pass this bill into law. Let there be music.
Cut. Beautiful. Moving.
Well, let's hear it, people. Give me some love from the Ghostlands.
Oh, it feels different in here.
Yeah.
Quiet.
Because Lord Mayfield is finally at peace.
Thank goodness. I can finally check my lip gloss. Maybe Margot was wrong about that.
Oh, he's mad as heck.
I can't open them. We're locked in here.
Don't push. Pull.
It's coming right outside.
For ages, what is wrong with you people?
Oh.
My ferret is loose in City Hall. If Sam hadn't forgotten his MP3 player and come back for it, I'd still be out there in the rain.
Have you seen my MP3 player? Do you have a tissue?
There, there. It's okay. We're back together again, Ferdinand. Oh, your beret is crooked. Let me. Ow!
Matching costumes?
Well, it's a very special night for us. Or at least it was.
I still don't believe it. You were the trick-or-treaters that Sam was talking about earlier.
Yes, it's our Halloween ritual, trick-or-treating at City Hall. But Ferdinand got out of his cage somehow. First, I didn't notice. And I saw him inside at one of the windows, but it was too late then. City Hall was locked up.
He ate the cupcake and brushed up against me.
It was Ferdinand we heard, not mice.
Well, I walked all around the building and kept knocking and knocking. No one heard me.
Oh, we heard you all right. We thought it was a ghost.
Ghosts? There's no such thing as ghosts.
See, I knew there was an explanation.
Well, I'm sorry we spoiled your fun. Drove Mo and Jarman away.
Ah, don't worry about it. They're in a rush to get home and start editing their exploitative internet film.
Okay. Now I really am scared.
You know what? Whether there's a ghost or not, I still feel good about passing Lord Mayfield's bill. I wouldn't want to leave office with unfinished business.
Let's see Pew try to enforce that music ban now.
Yeah, I'll just wave that old document right in his face. He wouldn't dare flaunt the wishes of Crotchley Mayfield.
So, what now? Home? Betty Bye?
Are you kidding? We got candy, we got costumes, we almost had a real live ghost. It's Halloween, people. I say we party.
Time for change, Jack. And I will bring that change to Mayfield.
Change.
Change that the citizens can see. Change that the citizens can feel. Change that the citizens can taste. Do you want to change Mayfield with me, Jack?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes!
It's 5 a.m.
You're late! Your call time was 04:30.
Call time?
The time you're supposed to show up on set?
To star in my internet film. Today! Now!
Right! Okay, I'm on my way.
No, no. Take your time. I only have 24. Oh, no. Make that 23 and a half hours left to shoot this.
Okay. 2 more minutes.
Don't even think about it.
Margo, I know you like movies, but to shoot a film in 24 hours?
It's the beauty of these online competitions. 24 hours to write the script, 24 hours to shoot it. I just love the challenge of creating art under pressure.
Well, good luck. I hope you win.
Listen, thanks for doing craft service. I know it's a tough job.
No problem. It's really more of a stepping stone. I plan on working my way up to the top. Coco?
Sure.
I made the marshmallows myself.
Wow. Oh, Becky! Perfect. We need to get you into hair and makeup ASAP. KK! Okay.
Oh, it's gonna take more time than I thought to get this ready for the silver screen. Hey,
that's okay. Ooh. So, what do you think of my script?
Right, I'll tell you in just one sec. It was awesome.
I wanted to focus on the thriller aspect of the new mayor, played by you, who has to deal with the ex-mayor who's out to get her.
Sounds good. I just have one little question.
I'm all ears. I consider myself somewhat of an actor's director.
The love story subplot with the ex-mayor's son?
Mm-hmm.
Who plays the son?
Hey.
Jack, baby. You ready to be a star?
Sure.
How do actors remember their lines?
Don't worry about it. You get lots of takes to nail them.
Okay, guys. Since we're in such a tight deadline, we're only gonna do one or two takes. Now, do you both know your characters' motivations?
Yes.
Yes.
All right.
Good.
Then let's roll.
Rolling, Mr. Director.
And action.
I knew I shouldn't have trusted your father, ex-Mayor Paddock, but I...
Cut! Let's try again. This time with feeling.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Ready, Jack?
Let's go.
Okay. And action!
I wouldn't trust Paddock as far as I could throw him!
Cut! That's not in the script.
I know, I improvised.
Okay, everyone take five.
You
want to
grab some
food? Becky, you don't know your lines, do you?
Okay, next.
No.
This is what we're going to do. I'm going to do a different scene, and in the meantime, I want you to rehearse your lines.
Oh, that would be great. Thank you. I promise I'll nail them next time.
I know you will.
Okay.
Okay, everyone, we're moving on to scene 38.
Ah, good evening, Mayor Fitchett. And good riddance. And see it.
Cry away, my friend. My acting has that effect on people.
I'm not crying. There's just something in my eye.
So what did you think?
Was it
too evil? Huh?
No. I'm thinking I want you more evil.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I can see how you might think that, but all of my creative instincts are telling me to take it down. Huh? Way down.
Yeah. Mm. No. Mm-mm. More evil.
Really? Well, this is good. This is good. You know why?
Why?
Because creative tension is the basis of all good art.
Uh-huh.
Really? Mm-hmm. So I just need you to visualize something with me, okay?
Okay.
Less evil, more likable.
Okay.
Yeah.
I need you to envision this.
Yeah.
You are the actor. Uh-huh. I am the director.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. You do what I say. See you in five.
Jack says to me, do the movie, Dad. You know? Show you have a sense of humor, people might even vote for you again. All it's doing is making me look bad. If only I had an agent. An agent would protect me from the tyrannical director.
I knew I shouldn't have trusted ex-Mayor Paddock. I hope this town remembers him. The evil tyrant that he is. Tyrant that he is!
The evil tyrant that he is.
That was awesome!
Thank you. Oh, I come from a family of performers, you know. Actors, singers, even a mime.
Miss D, I could really use your help. Acting is so much different than public speaking or doing interviews. I thought this was gonna be so easy.
Don't you worry. Now, I can not only act, but I used to direct theater, too. I have a knack for helping struggling thespians.
Oh, that's awesome.
Okay.
Okay.
Now, I want you to relax. Now, let me hear that line.
I knew I shouldn't have trusted ex-Mayor Paddock. I hope this town remembers him. For the evil tyrant that he is. How's that?
How much time do I have to get you into shape?
This film is
killing me. I have an actor with attitude and an actor who can't act. And I only have 15 hours left.
Don't stress. Ooh, you want something that'll help take your mind off things? Everything's peachy lip gloss.
I'm worried about Becky. If she can't pull off this role, I might have to recast her.
Hey, guys.
Becky!
Hey, can I talk to you for a sec?
Have you memorized your lines?
Well, I tried, but...
Becky...
I know. But I think I'd be a much better producer than an actor. And you have a lot on your plate right now. I could totally help you.
That could work.
No hard feelings?
Not at all. The show must go on. Ugh. Where am I going to find a talented, beautiful actress who has great on-screen chemistry with Jack?
I know the perfect person.
Where's your apron? Your tray?
What? I'm an agent now. And if you give my client, Mort Braddock, an on-screen credit before the title, I'll set you up with the perfect Becky.
No, I don't have time for this right now.
No, you don't, which is why you need to accept my demands. I walk away from this deal in 3, 2, 1.
Fine! Credit before my title, but smaller font than my credit.
Deal.
Now, who's this actress?
Oh. You're gonna love her.
At first, I didn't want to have anything to do with this lame film.
Lame? Marco and I are creating art.
Yeah, whatever. Just make sure you only shoot my good side. Anyways, when Mo told me I'd be playing Becky, I thought it would be fun in a twisted kind of way.
She has that certain je ne sais quoi. That Q factor that makes people stars.
Prima donna.
Thank you. All right, people, let's do this. Quiet on set. Roll camera and action.
City Hall is the type of place that destroys your soul.
She's being so melodramatic. I'm not that melodramatic.
City Hall ruined ex-Mayor Paddock. He's an egomaniac who lost his soul to corruption, deceit, and immorality.
I'm afraid, Mac. I'm afraid that ex-Mayor Paddock has it in for me.
Shh. Don't worry.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. I don't understand. This isn't in the script.
I know. Last minute rewrite. Isn't it great?
Mayor Fitchard, you're safe with me. No matter what happens, I will protect you from the nefarious, evil, soulless ex-Mayor Paddock.
Oh, Mac.
Cut!
What do you think you're doing? The only person who we know cut on the set is the director. That would be me.
Well, I'm your producer. So technically, I outrank you.
Yeah, but it's an unspoken rule. The scene is brilliant.
Oh, thanks.
Okay, but the kiss is ridiculous. I mean, it's a thriller. The nefarious, evil, soulless ex-mayor is about to take her down.
There. See? That's exactly what I'm talking about, right there. See that?
Yep.
And you, son, why are you saying these things about me?
It's called acting, Dad.
Mort, relax. I'm gonna take care of this. Here, have some cocoa. Come on.
Sorry, I can't do this. I'm sorry.
I know.
Hey!
Come on.
There's no time for a trite love story.
The kiss isn't about love. It's about two people bonding during a time of emotional crisis.
I think the kiss works.
Definitely, yes. It does.
It's pretentious, like the rest of your film.
Get off my set.
You can't kick me off the set. I'm your producer. But guess what? I quit.
Good. I continue making my masterpiece.
Keep dreaming. It's gonna be a box office flop.
Yeah, well, the kiss stays in the picture.
Ha.
All right, everyone, we're pushing the kiss scene to the end of the night. I don't want any negative vibes ruining Darcy and Jack's performance. We're on scene 18. German, do you have the wide-angle lens?
Wide-angle lens coming right up.
Okay.
It's empty.
What? Did you check the equipment before you signed it out?
Well, yes. And no. And more on the no side.
No amount of lip gloss is gonna solve this problem, Keeks.
No lip gloss this time. Just friendly advice. Maybe you should put your differences with Becky aside. You need a producer.
Forget Becky. She let her personal feelings interfere with my art.
Yeah, but maybe you could have been a little bit more sensitive to the situation.
Sensitive? How? I don't know, you could have prepared her for the fact that Jack would be kissing Darcy?
Kings, I have 7 hours to make this film. I don't have time to worry about people's feelings. The show must go on!
Please tell me that was the stunt glass for scene 27.
Nope, that was the wide-angle lens.
Let's go, people! Hustle, hustle!
You're back.
Come on back, out of my way. I've got a movie to shoot.
Can I see your permit?
Are you serious?
You need a permit to shoot at City Hall. Sure. Your producer should know that. Mm. Oh, wait! You don't have a producer!
Fine. You want me to get a permit? Who do I have to talk to?
What's this, Misty?
Oh, come on!
It's a film permit to shoot at City Hall.
Mm-hmm. They need 6 hours to shoot this thing? Tell them they can have four.
Four? But we...
Also, tell them if they don't like that, they can find another location to shoot at.
Sorry, Margot, but she's the mayor. You have 4 hours to shoot your film.
Let's do this. We have 4 hours and we can't afford to waste any. Darcy? Where's Darcy?
Hey, Margot. Mr. Braddock wanted to talk to you about the script.
Hmm. What about?
Well, it needs to be rewritten to make my character more heroic.
He's not the hero.
He can be. Just needs a few rewrites, that's all.
Come on, Dad. Give it a rest.
No, son, I won't. This is about artistic integrity.
No. It's about you wanting to look good so you can get votes, right?
Well, it's about all those things, isn't it? Huh? I mean, look at Reagan. Look at Schwarzenegger. They leveraged their acting careers to become powerful politicians, and they did it playing heroes.
I don't have any time to write any new scenes. Sorry.
Which is why I rewrote it for you.
You've got to be kidding me.
All I'm asking for is a co-writer's credit, low six figures, and 5% gross at the box office.
Darcy, oh, I'm so glad you're here.
Actually, I can't stay.
Excuse me?
I just got a part in a music video. I've got the right look, and it pays.
But what about my film?
My character is one-dimensional. I need to be challenged by my roles.
Created a monster. Mm.
See you on the red carpet.
Sell out!
Yeah. Hey, don't forget, I get 10%.
I've created two monsters.
It's over. I can't believe it's over.
You did your best, Margot. Don't be so hard on yourself.
I knew I shouldn't have trusted ex-Mayor Paddock. I hope this town remembers him for the evil tyrant that he is. What do you think?
Well, I am a tough director, and I do have a bit of a reputation for being a jerk. But on the whole, I'd say that was awesome.
The show must go on, right?
Really? All right, everyone, we have our leading lady back. So let's make some cinema magic!
I'm sorry I yelled cut.
I'm sorry I let my art get in the way of our friendship.
So you rescheduled the kissing scene with Jack for later on today?
I should go prep.
Ooh! Lip gloss?
Mm.
Actually, you were right about the kiss. It doesn't work, so I cut it out of the script. We have 2 hours, everyone! Move! Move!
Yeah, I remember when I used to do craft service. Feels like it was just yesterday. One second. Well, Brady's office. Please hold. It's Spielberg.
Hey, buddy, how are ya? Oh, yeah, really? That's great.
It's Stan Spielberg, his orthodontist.
Wait! This can't be! I thought you loved me!
Love? No. It was just a ruse to get you to trust me, so I could take over City Hall.
You're a tyrant, Matt Paddock! A diabolical tyrant!
Sorry I had to do that, son. But I am for justice. G. Mr. Gavel, someone had to stop your evil reign of terror.
Thank you, ex-Mayor Paddock. You saved my life. I owe you. This town owes you. For you are a hero.
Great film, Miss Director.
Nice shooting, Mr. Cameraman.
That was awesome.
Hey, making me the hero of the picture and Jack the villain was just the twist the story needed.
Yeah, I guess.
Listen, guys, I just want to say thank you. I couldn't have done it without you. Who wants to see the blooper reel?
Oh, yeah.
And we're rolling. You're a horrible Paddock tyrant. You're a horrible Paddock Braddock. You're a horrible tyrant Braddock.
Take over.
Mayor.
Mrs. Dean, get out of the shot.
Sorry.
Oh. Mustache.
So gross.
Wait, we're rolling? So I could take.
Baby.
Oh, yeah.
Margot's film looked so good.
Well, that's because she had the two best looking and most talented actors working for her.
This is a pin.
Yeah?
And this is me popping your overly inflated ego.
What? It's true. You really came through in the clutch. You memorized all your lines, and then you nailed them.
Miss D had a lot to do with that.
Yeah, sure, but in the end, it was all you.
Thanks.
Oh, and for the record, I'm just sad that we didn't get to do the kissing scene. I'm speaking from an artistic point of view, of course.
Of course.
Oh, sorry. I guess I'm still in character. Mayor Fitcher. Yes. The spicier and the saucier, the better.
Hey, there's your dad.
Oh, hey, Dad. Dad.
Jackson!
Jackson?
Yeah, Jack, son. It's my nickname.
Richards.
Maester Braddock? Mr. Braddock?
Just, getting some food for me and your mom. You know, she loves that soup, huh?
It's great soup. I love it too.
What?
The soup. It's good.
Oh, you like it too. Well, I better get going. Oh, she hates it when the soup gets cold. Mayor?
Your dad hates me.
No, he doesn't hate you. You're just not his favorite person right now. He's still a little sensitive about you calling him a crook and beating him in the election.
Well, it's not my fault he did what he did.
I know, but eventually he'll get over it. It's just gonna take some time.
Yeah, like 100 years.
No. Well, probably just 50.
Wayne, something wrong?
The landlord isn't gonna renew our lease.
What? Why?
He's gonna rent to the Three Ring Burger Corporation instead.
But they've already got a burger joint right across the street.
They want to build a new steakhouse here.
But they can't do that. This is like a second home to us.
It's my only home. Though, I guess it doesn't matter because in the news, Huffling's, a Mayfield institution for over 30 years, plus your favorite restaurant and mine, is about to close forever.
Girl who never really thought of fame in a place where no one even knew my name. So here I go.
got to be another place where you can build your restaurant. Like, what about someplace near Town Square? Really? Well, I could help you with the red tape on that. Okay, okay.
Bye.
Oh, that was the president of Three Ring Burger.
I figured.
He doesn't want any other place but Hoplings.
I figured that, too.
How can this even be happening? This is not fair. Hoplings is like a landmark in this town.
You supported that bylaw promoting new development in the city core.
Ooh, right.
Which is why Three Ring Burger decided to expand.
Well, when I supported that bylaw, I didn't think that this was gonna happen. Okay, fine. Now I wanna not support the bylaw. How do we undo it?
It's not so easy. And even if you could, it's too late to stop the deal.
Well, there's gotta be something I can do. I mean, I'm not going out without a fight.
Oh!
I'm okay. And it's all my fault. Don't be ridiculous.
The bylaw's gonna help revitalize downtown, which is a good thing.
I should have known something like this was gonna happen.
Really? I didn't know you had a psychic on the payroll.
Hey, Bex. I've been thinking. You should talk to my dad. He loves Hoplings. Maybe he could help.
Good idea.
Anytime. Well, I'm sorry to be so brilliant and then just run off, but I'm really late.
Okay.
Bad idea.
Yeah. I wouldn't ask Brooke Braddock for a favor if he was the last crooked ex-mayor on Earth. Seriously.
Come on, guys. I'm dying for a triple ringer combo.
Wait. We can't eat a Three Ring Burger. They're the enemy.
If anything, we should boycott that place.
I'm a genius.
Well, you want to sign our petition? It says you're boycotting Three Ring Burger until they reconsider their position on Hoplings. Thank you. You won't regret it.
Okay, so we wrote a protest song.
Take this steakhouse and shove it! Because we're never gonna love it! Like we love Hoplings.
That's why
we
sing
this song. Shutting it down and opening up a Three Ring Burger place in its space would just be play wrong.
So what do you think?
It's perfect. If you're hard of hearing.
Well, I mean, Jarman needs to rehearse a little more, but. So, you guys want autographs?
Yeah. Right on these.
Where's Kiki? I don't know. I'm guessing she's been delayed by some fashion-related emergency.
Mayor Richards, is it true you organized this protest?
Yes. A non-violent demonstration is a fundamental right of democracy.
But as mayor, aren't you worried about a conflict of interest?
I'm not here as Mayor Richards. I'm here as a regular citizen, just another happy Hoplings customer.
Isn't this stopping progress in your town? Progress that you yourself encouraged?
No, not at all. Hoplings has been a family-owned and run business for three generations. I mean, it's a landmark in this community, and we just want it to stay where it is.
Well, what do you hope to accomplish today?
I hope to meet with the president of Three Ring Burger and give him this boycott declaration.
Thank you. Thank you, Ms. Richards. Well, there you have it. Can a David mom-and-pop business beat a Goliath corporation? Stay tuned.
He wouldn't meet me. His secretary said I needed an appointment, and he's not even available until next month.
Too late for Hoplings, which I guess is the point.
Exactly.
Mayor, Citizen Richards, what's next?
I don't know. But stay tuned, because I've only just begun to fight.
Well, as you can see, Mayor Richards is very serious. Stay tuned, as this situation is just starting to heat up.
I wonder what happened to Kiki.
Kiki? Where were you? We were getting worried.
I'm gonna explain. No, I can't.
You signed the boycott agreement.
I know. I'm really, really sorry.
Kiki, our word is our bond.
I'm weak. I couldn't take it anymore. I was so craving a three-ring maxi meal. I was going through withdrawal, especially after I promised I wouldn't have any more.
It's the ultimate psychological torture.
I guess there's no point of throwing it out now. You already bought it. It sure smells good.
just get maybe a teeny little whiff?
We have it faster under my nose. Faster. Okay.
What do you hope to accomplish today?
I hope to meet with the president of Three Ring Burger and give him this boycott declaration.
Thank you, Mayor Richards.
It is a conflict of interest, Mayor Richards. Three Ring Burger pays taxes, too. You have to be mindful of what you say.
So because I'm the mayor, I can't have an opinion or exercise my democratic right like every other citizen of Mayfield?
Correct.
That's so not fair! I thought this would be one of those times when it would be good to be mayor. Where were you guys?
Working on the song.
Rewriting the lyrics.
Tweaking the tune.
Good. Sounds like it'll be ready by the time the new steakhouse is built.
Hey, dumplings, please, Wayne.
Soup for me. I'm not hungry.
Can I have more fried rice? I don't know what you guys did today, but it's awesome.
Hey, look at this. Public support is growing. 68% of people surveyed said they'll never eat at the new steakhouse.
On behalf of myself and my whole family, thank you. I'll go put in your orders.
It's a grassroots movement, Bex. Public sympathy is on our side.
People love an underdog.
Just wait till we sing our song, then you'll really see sympathy.
See, I knew we shouldn't give up.
Everyone has to leave right now.
Why?
The health inspector has ordered us to shut down.
What?
What?
I don't understand.
We are being charged with unsanitary food preparation. They say they found dog hair in our rice. Mm. Oh, dude!
Keep your food to yourself. Well, yeah.
So, no Kiki or Margo for moral support?
Sometimes you have to do things by yourself. I'm really glad you're here, though.
Yeah, me too.
Mayor Richards. Yes, it is. Welcome to my humble hacienda. So, how can I help you?
Hoplings was closed down by the health inspector, but Wayne swears the restaurant's really, really clean.
Oh, the old dog hair on the rice trick, I'll bet, huh? Was it? It's a classic.
Who would do something like that?
Who do you think? Your protest is gaining support, and so Three Ring had to fight back. And they're doing that by turning public opinion against Hoplings.
I was just trying to get Three Ring to change their minds, but...
But you messed it up.
Yeah, I guess so.
No, you did, trust me.
That. The point is she's here, and she needs your help.
So why didn't she ask me herself?
I need... Your
Come on, you can do it. It won't take a second.
Help! Help!
There we go. That wasn't so hard, was it?
No, not at all. It's a cake.
So, you want me to stop Three Ring?
If you can.
Oh, if I can, I'd be honored to. Because, you know, Hoplings is not just a part of Mayfield history. I've actually been going there since the very beginning. Look what I found. Isn't that great? Of course, that was before the facade was all renovated. It's an old, old building. It's easily over 100 years old. Underneath all that paint and guck, there's some pretty remarkable brick and stonework. So, as you can see, I'm pretty sympathetic to the cause, but you are the mayor. And so far, you haven't been able to come up with a solution. So I'm not quite sure what you expect me to do.
Well, I was kind of hoping maybe you had a political trick up your sleeve, or you could call in a favor. But nothing illegal. Other than that, I'm open to all suggestions.
I'm sorry. There's honestly nothing I can do.
Could you maybe get the ban thing lifted off Hoplings?
No. Fasten, you can say extra spicy dumplings. I'll make a call.
Thanks. I appreciate it.
Well, excuse me.
See? I told you, your dad hates me.
He's coming around. I can tell. Your worst favorite ascot.
So you asked for his help, and he turned you down?
There was nothing he could do.
I can't believe you went to see him in the first place.
Well, I told Wayne I'd do whatever it took.
Yes? How may I help? Oh, may I? Mr. Bradhawk.
Top of the morning, Mrs. D.
Well, how are you?
I gotta go.
What brings you in here?
I've never been better. And I... Ah! Mayor Richards.
Mr. Braddock.
In the flesh. May I come in?
Yes. My office is always open for Mr. Mort Braddock.
Mrs. D, would you kindly bring us in those old Mayfield bylaw books?
Yes, ma'am. Mr. Braddock.
I haven't been in here since that unfortunate tripping incident.
They obviously didn't get that memo.
Sorry. Force of habit.
Please. Stay where you are.
Thanks. Yeah, if you insist. It is the most comfortable chair in the room. And in my back is still a little sore from that skateboard accident.
So, what are you doing here exactly?
Well, I decided to put our past differences aside and help you stop Three Ring.
Really? What made you change your mind?
The hot and sour soup. It's bigger than both of us.
Do you have any ideas?
I do. All we have to do is find a municipal technicality that prohibits them from building a steakhouse on that site.
Mr. Bradhawk.
Ah, Mrs. D, perfect timing as usual. Yep.
Did you know that there are many obscure, goofy, even downright dumb bylaws still on the Mayfield books? For instance, did you know that it is illegal to wear a fake mustache causing laughter in church? Or that it is a misdemeanor to yell at any wild animal while riding a bicycle, unless it's a whale.
You're kidding.
No, I'm not. So all we have to do is find some sort of wacky bylaw that suits our needs.
Some of these bylaws are pretty out there. I mean, it's illegal to spit on a buffalo from the second story of a hotel. Weird. Too bad there's nothing in there about replacing a Vietnamese restaurant with a steakhouse.
Unfortunately, there's nothing here we can use. Huh. Surprised, actually.
If only Hop Ling's had some sort of historical importance, you know, we could preserve it that way. Like Lord Mayfield's house.
At least you got the health inspector to let them reopen. Even if it is for just one more day.
It was Mr. Braddock who did that. I just wish I could do more, though.
I can't believe this is our last meal here. I'm so filling up on dumplings till I burst.
Guys, it was really nice of Wayne's parents to do this final feast for all the regular customers.
There's already a wrecking ball, a dump truck, a bulldozer, and a moving van out there.
Yeah, they're not wasting any time.
Awesome chow, Wayne, as usual.
It certainly was. Compliments to the chef.
You guys don't have to go yet. There's still lots of time left.
Hey, guys, let's move this table.
Yeah, right, right. Okay, let's do it.
Thanks.
What are you doing?
Staging a sit-in. Protest this injustice.
And stop them from bulldozing this place.
You can't do that. You're gonna get in trouble. Civil disobedience has a proud and long history in this country. But I'm only gonna stay if you don't play. Okay?
Is it okay if I stay on the chair? What? This is dry clean only. Yeah.
All right, coming. But I can't condone this type of behavior. I'm supposed to remain neutral.
Becky, it's okay. You did what you could, and we understand that, but we don't have to sit on the sidelines, so it's the floor for us.
Right, guys?
Yes.
Solidarity.
Okay, I'm sorry, guys. I mean, I don't like this any more than you do, but the lease is up at midnight. I mean, if you guys stay here past that, you're gonna be breaking the law.
Yeah. Yeah. Today we make history.
Yeah! Okay, how does
that track go again? History! That's it! Jack, call your dad and ask him to bring that picture of himself from Hop Ling's.
What for?
Don't ask me any questions, just do it!
Explain this to your father, would you?
Dad, Becky needs you to bring the picture of you in front of Hop Ling's.
Hey, Mrs. D. Could you go down to City Hall and grab those bylaw books and bring them to Hop Ling's?
Yes, for Becky.
I know it's past hours, but it's really important.
Please.
Please.
We love Hop Ling's!
Thanks, Miss D. But you don't have to stick around.
Are you kidding? I wouldn't miss this for anything.
Tick-tock.
I may be the mayor, but I don't care. You guys are my friends, and you need my support. So, here.
Oh, hi.
Mr. Braddock.
Yeah. Is that what you wanted?
Yeah, this is it. Thank you. This is possibly a heritage site, and until you determine either way, you can't knock it down.
According to my piece of paper, you gotta vacate the premises now.
No, she does not, sir. And please don't try to bully the mayor. She does have the law on her side.
I know.
Very nice, very nice.
So they can't tear it down just because it's old?
Not just old. It's a prime example of 19th century architecture, which gives it historic value that must be preserved.
All right, everyone, you can go home now. Hoplings isn't going anywhere for a long time.
Congratulations.
Hey. Good job.
Let's go, let's go.
Well, we did it. We saved this place.
We sure did.
I still can't quite believe it.
Me either. Nonetheless, have you savored your accomplishments enough for tonight?
Almost. Can I have another minute, though?
I will grant you an additional 60 seconds.
I guess I just don't want this feeling to end. I kind of feel bad for Three Ring, though.
You can't be serious.
I know, it's crazy. I mean, they're just gonna build their steakhouse, the first place I initially offered them, and everyone will be happy in the end.
You guys aren't gonna believe this, but I'm hungry.
Oh, as fate would have it, we're in a restaurant, and though they're closed, I think they'd make an exception for us.
But I don't know what I'm in the mood for. Dumplings?
Always.
What about spring rolls?
Yeah, with extra plum sauce.
Or how about that fried rice that Jarman spit on Mo? Didn't that look good?
Yeah, let's get some of that. What about you, Bex?
I'm starving.
You want your usual?
No. Oh. I'm kind of in the mood for a three-ring maxi burger.
Hoplings really loves you, but I don't think even you can get that here.
Why would you want one anyway?
Excuse me? You were the one shoveling in your face the other day.
Yeah, I forgot.
Besides, I really want extra onion rings and a double vanilla shake.
Mm. Oh, that sounds so yummy. I think I'll have one too.
What? You got me in the mood. Opening of Mayfield's first all-ages club, a cool way to meet, have fun, and stay out of trouble. Kiki, I need your help with this. Margo's at the mummification workshop.
Right, sorry. Yeah, it looks great. Love the font. Totally all-agey.
I'll get it. Hello? Oh, hi. Yeah, of course I'm going. It is part of my teen action initiative. No, not with anyone special. What about you?
Is it Jack?
Shh. Yeah, I guess we could go together.
Ah, is he asking you out?
Shh. Yeah. I mean, I don't see why not.
It's a date, Becky. Just say yes.
Shh.
And then... Ow! Say yes.
Right. Okay. Sounds good. Bye.
And you call yourself a friend?
It's not what you think it is.
Of course it is! It's a date with Jack Braddock, your first official date!
Not true. We had a date before.
A fake date? This is the real one where he actually called you.
It's not a big deal.
Why won't you share this with me? Me, who pulled you from the sandbox in kindergarten right before Billy Corbett peed in it. You owe me this.
Sorry, you're right. I guess it is a date.
Ah, I'm so happy for you!
Bex?
Club.
What?
A girl can't go to an opening like this without a date. Not if her best friend has one.
So what? Just come with us. I mean, I would never let a date get in the way of our friendship. I'd rather call the whole thing off.
Becky, bad news. I'm gonna have to cancel our, thing on Friday.
What? You mean our date?
Yeah. You see, the thing is, my cousin Brad and I plan to spend spring break hanging out, and my dad got his Stallion tickets for Friday. Brad's a big football fan, so I'm really sorry.
No big deal. Really. It's cool.
Go. Oh, you're handling this very well.
Well, my old, less mature self would have wanted to kill him, but my new adult mayor self is totally cool with it.
She's totally lying.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Fortune cookie on the house?
Since when does Hoblings have fortune cookies?
Since I just bought one from the Chinese bakery 5 minutes ago.
Wayne, please. You're 13.
So? One day I won't be. Check out your fortune.
It's true. It's true.
A dashing younger man will escort you to the all-ages club on Friday.
There you go. Now you have a date. Yay!
There's no way. I'm not going out with that child.
Ew.
Oh my gosh, I need cold water! Cold water, cold water, cold water! Jack, at your 12 o'clock. At 12 o'clock!
Becky!
Hey there.
Hey. I want you to meet my cousin Brad. Brad, that's Becky, and this is her friend Margo.
Hi!
Yeah, hi.
Jack's cousin.
Becky, you have no idea how much I've heard about you. It's always, you know, Becky says this, and Becky says that. Hey. Sorry about stealing him away from you for the week. We didn't really synchronize our calendars.
Yeah.
Do you want to join us?
Great, just, where's the...
Oh, right, washroom's that way.
Yeah, thanks, buddy.
Ow!
Oh, I'm...
Just watch where you're going!
Sorry.
It's okay.
Hi, I'm Brad. Hi, Kiki.
Was that just love at first sight?
Or static electricity?
You peel your banana from the bottom?
Uh-huh.
So do I.
That's amazing. I thought I was the only one. Look, a squirrel.
I just love squirrels.
Me too.
Which one's your favorite, black or gray?
I like the black ones. Black goes with everything.
Me too.
Oh, we have so much in common, it's unbelievable. Oh, I just love oxygen, don't you? And we're both breathing it. We have so much in common.
Stop it.
Let me guess, e-card from Brad?
He's so amusing. You know, Bex, it really pains me that while Brad and I have achieved such happiness and bliss in such a short time...
I'll say, 3 hours. Almost.
You and Jack have failed to fully harmonize.
Becky! Look, it just hit me. This goofball here chose tickets to a football game over a date with you this Friday.
It's not a date, honest. It's fine.
No! This is not fine. Look, I've learned a few things about the human heart since I've met Kiki. Can I have that ticket back now, bud?
Yeah.
I can spend Friday night with Becky. And Kiki, would you care to share in my other great love?
You mean football?
It's one of the most romantic things I've ever seen.
He's going too far with this. All I said was I didn't want to cancel Friday. I was looking forward to it.
Really? Me too.
Romance rules.
Oh, yeah? Just wait for the other shoe to drop.
Hey, Wayne.
What's up?
What's Jack's cousin got that I don't?
3 years, killer abs, charisma.
Exactly. Nothing. I gotta get Kiki away from that guy.
Take it from me, man. That's the last thing you should do. Wait it out. You're not going anywhere. Kiki's not going anywhere. But Brad's going home. Next week. And when that happens, Kiki will remember just how gracious you were in romantic defeat. And maybe pity you. Which you can take full advantage of.
Wow. You sounded just like Mo.
I'm channeling him. He's away for the week.
Cool. Thanks for the advice.
Looks great, Marco.
I'm sorry I won't be at the opening, Bex.
Yeah, me too.
Nice.
You understand, though. Me meeting Brad, going to the football game together. It was destiny.
Thanks. How are those balloons coming?
Yeah, we got lots to do tonight.
Oh, right. Sorry. If I can't be there at the opening, I'll be here for you now.
Keeks! You will not believe my luck. I got us 2 tickets to the advanced screening of Vampire Love, last minute, tonight only.
That's fantastic! I'm dying to see that movie. I read all the books.
Yeah, me too.
Except, I'm busy, remember? I promised Becky and Margo I'd help put up decorations for the opening on Friday.
Yeah, right. Yeah, just one little thing. You know, they live here, right? And I'm gonna be gone in a week. Wait a minute. Did I just sound like a jerk or what? Look, I'm sorry. Take two. Apologies. Ladies, I withdraw.
Go.
You know you want to.
Really? Thanks! You guys are the best!
Okay. They live here and I go back in a week? Does that sound a little manipulative?
Who knew loving a vampire could be so complicated?
Bloody.
Yeah, the special effects were awesome.
I'll say, it was way better than the book.
Yeah. Kiki.
Brad.
Dumplings, there you go. Thanks, man. Hot sauce?
The hotter the better. Bring it on.
You know, this is a great town. Awesome people. Yeah. And of course, has you in it.
Oh, it's blue, man.
Bring it on.
What? Oh, thank goodness. Come here.
Quiet. I'm just getting takeout. It's like he's waiting for me.
How does it feel to be so adored?
I know why Brad finds me lovable. I find me lovable. It's one of the things we have in common. It's just that I don't know how to put this, Margot. It's pretty confusing. Thing is, he's driving me crazy!
What? But I thought you were all swoony.
It was, until I realized I couldn't breathe. It feels like I'm in a straitjacket. The trick is, can I make it through the next couple days? I can do that, right?
Yeah, of course. What's a couple of days?
Okay.
Just breathe.
Okay, he's coming back from the washroom now.
He's texting.
Never mind.
Good luck.
Bradsky!
Hey!
Hi.
You miss me?
Uh-huh. Everything good?
Dynamite. Listen, I just had the greatest idea. You ready?
Okay, maybe.
Brad Webster and Kiki Kincaid. Not only in the same school, but in the same class.
But you live in a different town.
Not if I move to Mayfield.
Move to Mayfield?
Yeah, the Braddocks are family, and they have tons of room. I can move in with them.
Really?
Plus, they have these real estate flyers outside the washroom. It may seem a little lame, but I actually get a kick out of looking at these. Helps you focus on your future, don't you think? I love that house. I love it. Too much garage, though. Not enough yard. I want to put a big swing set in my yard. A six-seater.
A six-seater swing set?
Yeah, I guess I'm kind of old-fashioned, so I want a lot of kids. Just like the names for our kids. They're old-fashioned, too. You know, David, Michael, James and Sarah, Little Nancy.
Okay.
Gladys and Gertrude, Kiki Cakes. We're gonna have such a wonderful family.
Yeah.
Girl conference.
I gotta go. Okay, bye.
What's up? What's up? Michael and David and James and Nancy and Sarah and William. That's what's up.
Who are they?
My children.
Wow, things really are moving fast between you and Brad.
It's far more serious than that. Mr. Perfect is moving to Mayfield.
Oh. All I wanted was a date for the All Ages Club. Instead, I get a boyfriend who wants to spend the rest of his life with me.
This has to be stopped.
What do you mean? That I should break up with him?
Absolutely.
Well, if I break up with Brad, then Jack might feel sorry for him and break off his date with Becky again. It's him! I can't answer it.
Okay. Kiki, calm down. Breathe.
The guy has to go. The only question is how to do it without upsetting Jack.
Well, what would be perfect is if he broke up with Kiki.
Yeah, but how realistic is that? I mean, look at me.
Unless it's not you that he's breaking up with.
You mean
reverse makeover.
Ooh, it sounds painful.
It will be, because we're starting in my closet.
Hi, Brad.
Hey. How you doing?
Have you seen Kiki around?
No, not yet. Oh, but before she gets here, I need your help with something. I've been trying to find a nice restaurant that I could take her to for special. What do you think?
kind of formal.
Well, that's the point. Plus, I reserved a window seat so I can show my Kiki Cakes off. Oh, she's so stylish and elegant and refined.
Hey, everybody! Rock on! How's it going?
Kiki?
Oh, hey, Bradzy. What's up? Oh, flowers for me?
Yeah.
Allergies, sorry. Where's German?
She said, where's German?
Here I am, double K.
You ready?
You bet, I've been practicing.
You call that practicing?
They do this every week. It's warm up for drama class.
It's great for the diaphragm. Mm. Sorry, that one just slipped out.
Bonus.
I know. I'll catch you later, cutie.
Wow. After one day, Kiki feels so comfortable with you that she can totally be herself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You're a keeper, Brad.
Kiki in a belching contest. And she won.
There are so many sides to that girl.
Just wait till she gets to know you better.
Full of surprises. Makes me like her even better.
What?
Well, who wants a girl that's predictable and boring? You know what I mean?
Drastic action.
What do you call this?
You should just tell Brad the truth. You probably should have in the first place.
Yeah, but what about you and Jack?
You're way more important. If our relationship depends on you and Brad going out, then it's not worth having.
That is, like, so totally mature.
I'll say.
And you're right. It's the best thing to do for both of us. I just hope I can go through with it.
Aww. Of course you can. Just be honest.
Brad, honesty is really important to me. So, I'm just gonna be straight with you.
Kiki?
I'm moving to Transylvania.
I'm sorry, what?
Like in the movie, you know, Vampire Love? The girl, she moves to Transylvania?
Pennsylvania.
Right.
Look, Kiki, I need to talk to you. I think you should sit down.
No. I think you should sit down first.
No, I'm not quite sure how I'm supposed to say this, but...
Let me say what I have to say first.
Kiki, I'm breaking up with you.
Are you insane?
It's not you. It's me. I mean, I just broke up with my longtime girlfriend. But she called me last night, and it looks like, well, you know.
Hmm?
Look, I'm sorry, Kiki. I think it's best if I just go home.
Hey, wait a minute. Was I a rebound girlfriend?
Right. There's no girlfriend.
What? Then why were you...
The frizzy hair, the outfit, the belching. I mean, I tried to deny it, but Kiki, even I'm not that thick. You don't feel the same way I do. But you didn't want to hurt me, right?
Sort of.
The thing is, if somebody tries that hard not to be with you, you need to hear them. And I like you way too much to impose myself on you anymore.
That is, like, so sweet.
Yeah, well, sometimes you just gotta punt, right?
Hmm.
Walk it to your car, bud?
Yeah, sure.
Brad? We'll always have hoplings.
You bet we will. Kiki cakes.
Now get this outfit off me.
Food, drinks, music. Check, check, and check.
Wow, the place looks great.
Thanks. I just hope we're not forgetting anything.
You've done everything you can.
Now relax before it gets crazy in here.
Yeah, Bex. Save some of your energy for the dance floor.
What's up, Keeks?
You okay?
Maybe I made a mistake about Brad.
What?
He was a really sweet guy. How often do you find poems taped to the sidewalk in front of your house?
I'm still waiting.
Well, if you ask me, Brad going back home was the best thing that could happen. Brad is great for a visit, but if I had to live with him, I mean, come on, the guy's got no off button. I'd be in a body cast.
Chocolates and flowers the first day should have been a warning sign. I mean, you can't rush relationships. Look at you guys. Wayne!
Kiki, seeing as you don't have a date for the club tonight, may I have the honor?
Flowers and chocolate. Have a seat, champ.
I'll just leave you two to your business.
Hello?
Good day, Mayor Richards. I'm calling to suggest you come a few minutes early this afternoon. You have a long list of people to interview.
Right. Thanks. This is Dee. She's like a drill sergeant, always regimenting my life.
Mayor, budget meeting in 8 minutes. Sign here, 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 and here. You need to read these to prepare for tomorrow's caucus.
I'm really looking forward to her being gone for a week. I need the break.
What about getting someone to help you?
I'm hiring a temp. Somebody who's not gonna boss me around, tell me what to do, or schedule the life out of me.
So you don't want someone competent?
No, I want someone who knows I'm the boss.
I am so impressed with you, Mayor Richards. You have, at such a young age, accomplished so much. And I don't mean to gush, but you really are an inspiration to dreamers everywhere. And I would really love the opportunity to just be around your amazing energy. And I would value the opportunity to help you with your mayoral duties in any way that I can.
You're hired!
Hear you. You gotta speak up from the diaphragm. Miss, what is your name? Yell it out!
Problem, Counselor Pugh?
Yes! Yes. Your temp here speaks in dog whistle tones that can't possibly be heard by mere humans.
Well, maybe if you didn't yell so loud, then you could hear something other than your own voice.
I'm not yelling! I'm speaking audibly.
Don't take him too seriously. He gets mad all the time. Should try and enjoy this week. Work can be fun, right? Like you don't have to have your hair up like that. Unless you want to. And the whole suit thing? Not necessary. Look at me, and I'm the mayor. Oh, and let's not get too mental about time, all right?
Okay.
That does, however, sound like it's time for lunch. You wanna go grab something?
With you, Mayor Richards?
Yeah. Call me Becky. Becky.
Awesome tone, dude.
I'll download it for you. It'll only take 2 seconds.
Better not. My phone's been acting weird lately, and I don't want to mess with it.
Oh, okay. Cool. He'll thank me next time his phone rings with that cool...
Hey, ready to go?
You're welcome.
For what?
Well, for being honest about breaking your phone so you don't have to learn the hard way the next time you try to use it.
Killed my phone?
I didn't kill it. It was already sick. I put it out of its misery.
No, I don't want to hear it. I told you not to mess with my phone, but you did anyways. Because you always know best, right?
So are you temping because you like it? Or is there something else that you want to do?
Oh, there's definitely something else that I want to do. I'm not really the office-y type. Not that I don't enjoy this job.
Oh, no, it's okay. I didn't take it personally. So what else are you into?
Poetry.
What?
Promethean poetry. Promethean means courageously original. So it's kind of like poetry, but performed with a lot more fire.
Cool. Can I hear one of your pieces? Come on, I've never heard poetry before. Please?
Birds snap like twigs on the forest floor. Door slam, window breaks. My heart does not and it kicks me, so I take to its back. You need to learn how to read. That's it.
That was amazing!
Really? You're not just saying that?
Are you kidding? Your poem was
sorry, your prom was awesome.
Well, actually, it was a poem. I didn't really perform it.
Well, next time you are performing, let me know. I'm totally there.
Oh, until now, I've never said my poems out loud.
No way.
Yes way.
Oh, well, that's gotta change. I mean, with your talent, you gotta bring that fire out into the world. I'm so excited. I'm a genius. I'm a genius. I'm a genius. Who's a genius? That would be me.
Guess what? You're a genius.
Good guess. I just signed Crystal up for a poetry slam.
Are you kidding?
What did she say?
Well, I haven't told her yet.
Oh.
Nee.
Are you sure you're a genius? Because I don't think this is one of your better ideas.
How come?
She just seems really nervous about everything, all the time.
Aw.
And when she speaks, I have to read her lips to understand what she's saying.
Ah, she'll be fine. She just needs a little encouragement. Don't worry, I'll help you. You're gonna be great.
I don't know, Mary Richards.
Becky.
Becky,
I've never performed in front of actual people before. What if I'm terrible? No, no, no. You just need to practice so that you feel comfortable, and then you're gonna be amazing. Keep breathing. I would not take the moon from the sky. Sorry to interrupt, but you need to turn around.
Not for fear of depriving millions of its nighttime splendor.
Okay, really need to see your face. Not for the fear of start again, but with more feeling. I would never take the moon from the sky. You call that feeling? Give me more, Crystal, more! I would never take the moon from the sky. Good, keep going. Not for the fear of depriving millions of its nighttime splendor. Excellent! But for the fear of having nowhere to keep it! No one, Sam. Crystal's reciting.
What kind of reciting emits such a blood-curdling shriek?
Sorry, it's like poetry, but with more fire.
Poetry, but with... You're a poet!
You've heard of it?
Of course! Poetry is a very old and respected art form in my country. The hot cup of milk sits on the table. Oops! Smash! What a mess!
Wasn't me!
I didn't do it!
Wow.
What's going on?
Ask German.
Nothing's going on. I'm just having my fries, enjoying the peace and quiet, because I don't have a phone.
Who do we sit with?
I'm thinking... either of them.
Crystal, have you seen the zoning bylaws? Ow! Oh. Never mind. Found it.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hey, where are you?
At work.
Oh,
I thought you'd be on your way here already. Where?
Hopplings.
There's something going on with Jarman and Mo,
and I think we should help.
What happened?
I don't know. Something about a phone. Anyways, I left a message with Opal.
You mean Crystal?
Yeah, whatever. Didn't you get it?
No. You know, a lot of people feel that way.
Yes, it's true. Oh, me, Rebecca, I did not see you standing there. You've become stealthy like a panther, crawling in the night. Panther, panther, panther!
Okay. Sorry to interrupt this. But I just have a quick question for you. Mm-hmm. My friend Margot called, left me a message.
I forgot. Oh, no.
Okay, we'll just try to remember that next time, okay?
I've disappointed you. I'm sorry.
Well, that was different. I guess being a pro, it's really hard.
Well, yes, they can be rather skittish. Crawling in the night. Pro it.
Don't worry, Crystal. It's just a message. It's not life or death.
But I feel awful. You've been so nice to me, and then this is the thanks you get. Well,
really, it could happen to anyone.
Even now, instead of being angry with me, you're here wondering how I feel.
Who's answering the phones?
No, I can't hear you. What's that? No, I can't hear you. Hello? Well, no, it would be very improper for me to write that word.
I apologize for being such a baby.
It's just that you're the first person that's ever been supportive of my work.
So sad. Some people just don't get it.
But you do. Which, you know, is one of the things that I admire about you. It's one of the reasons why I care what you think.
Oh, well, you know. Yeah. Woo!
Hey, want to sit with us?
You're not mad at me anymore?
No, I'm done with that.
Great. But I'm actually just getting fries with my new best friend, Charmin. Is this the guy with the temper problem? Yeah. You know, you need to show more emotional control. It's a sign of maturity.
How long do you plan on keeping this up?
Forever. Schmarman is a great friend. He's pleasant company, and he doesn't get overly upset over not a good enough reason.
Huh. As riveting as all this is, I need to remind the three of you to get it together in time for the poetry slam tonight.
Yeah, Becky's been working really hard coaching this girl, so you guys better not do anything to wreck it.
Mm-hmm.
Tell him.
Wreck it? I'm wounded. Me and Schmarman are slab happy.
Crystal, what are all these boxes doing in here?
I signed for them.
These are for the city mall, not city hall.
Really?
I wonder what they are.
I think they might be cuckoo clocks.
Yeah. Do you want to call the store and get them removed, please?
Right away.
Okay.
Hello, Mayor Rebecca. I brought you a small living thing.
Sam, it's so pretty. What is it?
It's a Venus fly trape.
A Venus fly who?
Trape. You know, trape. I got you. You see how delicate and fragile it looks? But don't pull the wool over your eyes. This cute little thing is carnivorous.
Carnivorous?
Mm.
A plant that eats meat?
Bugs, to be exact.
Thanks for thinking of me.
You're most welcome. You know, it's just a little reminder that all things that appear delicate may not be so benign.
Wait a minute.
Yes?
Are you talking about Crystal?
Would it make sense to you if I was?
No. Crystal's nothing like that plant. She's just really sensitive because she's an artist and she needs to be protected and nurtured. If you don't see that, then you just don't understand.
Hmm. Oh, well. It all depends on how you see the shadow cast on the hillside.
Hi, I'm Crystal, and this is the breakup. Hard snap! Like twigs on the forest floor. A door slams. A window breaks.
My heart does not have a kick me sign taped to its back. You need to learn how to read. Becky, hi. I want you to meet Helga and Dieter. Hi, pleased to meet you. They've offered me a spot in the major poetry festival in Berlin. Very bleak, very important. Oh, that's awesome! Wow! So how long has this festival been going on for? Oh, sorry. They believe that words are not to be wasted, so they've taken a vow of almost silence. Oh, I get it. I thought it was me that they were. That's hard.
Get out of here.
Poplings?
Yeah. Whoa, wait. Schmarman, somebody stole him. You took him, didn't you? You just couldn't stand what me and that little guy had together. Are you listening to yourself, man? First of all, you're talking about a sock puppet. And second of all, I'd never do anything like that, even if we are mad at each other. And you of all people should know that. True. My bad. Mine too. We cool? Affirmative. Yeah.
Mayor's office? Yes. The mayor's currently in a meeting. Can I take a message? Okay. I'll make sure that she gets it. Bye-bye.
Putting on a fake voice and taking your own messages.
Yeah, well, I didn't want people to know that I was actually answering my own calls.
Oh, I'm sorry, but I was up all night with Helga and Dieter drinking black coffee and talking about poetry. It was amazing!
Dieter and Helga actually spoke? Wow. That is amazing.
Ah! I expected to see you at the meeting this morning.
What meeting?
The meeting to decide which company would supply the new city buses.
That meeting is until tomorrow.
No, there was a scheduling foul-up. It got moved up. We voted this morning.
Oh, no!
Oh, yes. And we awarded the contract to the company with the lowest quote, which is the fiscally responsible thing to do.
Are they the greenest?
If by greenest you mean the color of the buses, then yes. And if you mean eco-fuzzy adorable footprint, then no.
You knew I was championing for the hybrid buses.
Then you shouldn't have missed the meeting.
I didn't know there was a meeting.
It even left you a note and a package with the competing bids.
When? I never got it.
Days ago, with that vocally challenged temp of yours.
I forgot.
You forgot? Just like that. Do you know what this means? It means stinky, gas-guzzling buses running all over Mayfield, that's what?
But you're the one who told me not to take that Pew guy too seriously, that he gets mad all the time.
That doesn't mean that you should ignore his messages. While we're on the subject, what else have you forgotten to tell me?
I will not let anyone speak to me that way, especially not a kid.
Oh, that's it. You're so fired!
You can't so fire me. Because I so quit! But!
What the heck happened here?
Welcome back, Mrs. D. One dozen of your favorite Mrs. Fairfax's cupcakes, which I promise not to take back, eat, covet, or insist that you share with me. Those yummy, taste-delicious treats are yours and yours alone.
You hired a bad temp, didn't you?
Why would you say something like that? Can't a mayor appreciate her associate and just be happy that she's back safe and sound?
Yes, I suppose a mayor can.
Yay!
Oh, thank you.
I feel really appreciated.
A Venus flytrap? Now, where did this come from?
Sam gave that to me, but I thought you might like it on your desk.
Oh, I do. Yes, that's gonna come in real handy during mosquito season.
Ew! Oh, I need you to call an emergency meeting with the transportation committee.
Oh, because the green buses didn't get the contract? I'll get right on it.
There's also this other thing. You get what you give, so let yourself live. Be what you're meant to be. To get used to having a teen mayor. It took a while for me to get used to being one, too, but I'm totally comfortable now, in control. That's why I'm giving you full access to my life at City Hall.
Good morning, Mayor Rebecca.
Good morning, Sam. Sam's our head of security. He keeps everyone safe around here.
Can I see some identification, please?
Maybe a little too safe. It's okay, Sam, they're with me. They're doing a day in the life of a teen mayor.
Well, how do you know?
They're with WNT.
Did they show you any identification?
There's news trucks outside. They have cameras on them.
News trucks and cameras to you, but to a trained security expert such as myself, a Trojan cow.
Trojan horse.
Where?
No, Sam, never mind. This is Mayfield.
Nevertheless, I shall ask you, gentlemen, to show me some identification. Or I shall be forced to subdue you with the ancient art of Wing Chun.
I think we should take you to the doctor.
No. I'll be all right.
Here you go.
No, all that matters, Mayor Rebecca, is that this man is who he says he is.
Thanks.
Now I must go do my round.
He's very dedicated. Where were we? Oh, yeah. It took a while for everyone to get used to having a teen mayor. But teens can do anything. We're actually very responsible. That's why I put my friends Kiki and Margo in key advisory positions. Contrary to what people believe, teenagers aren't all about sleeping in and surfing the internet all day.
Becky, Margo, and I have been friends, like, forever. I do a lot of speech writing for Mayor Richards, and I advise her in political and business affairs.
And I advise her on hair, makeup, wardrobe, and try to keep her up to date on celebrity and gossip affairs. You know, the important stuff.
It's time for today's agenda, Mayor.
Mrs. DeMarco, my executive assistant. Without her, I'd be completely lost.
Without me, everyone around here would be completely lost. I keep everybody on schedule, on point, and I do it in a no-nonsense kind of way. I expect my mayors, and I have served under the last four, to act professionally and to strive for perfection.
Okay, hit me with my daily schedule.
Good morning, Mayor Richards, Mrs. DeMarco, all the loyal WNT viewers. I have a question. Are you tired of batteries that are always running out of power? Well, with the new handy Pew shoe charger, you'll never run out of power again. And if anyone knows about power, we do.
Counselor Pew, we're not allowed to make on-air endorsements of products.
Fine. Then you leave me no choice. Are you familiar with Spoke Hudson?
That's the bike enthusiast who's lobbying for...
Bike-only streets in Mayfield. Yes, I'm familiar with Mr. Hudson. His file's here. Somewhere?
Well, Spoke Hudson asked me to approach you because you haven't taken action on any of his recommendations.
That's because he... That's because he uses strong-arm tactics, and I won't be forced into making a decision. If he wants to debate the bike-only streets in Mayfield, he knows where to find me.
Debate? What's to debate about? Mayfield is too smoggy, and bike-only streets would seriously reduce pollution.
Well, you own two cars, a minivan, and an SUV.
La, 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 la. Spoke Hudson is threatening action if you don't make Mayfield streets bike-only. Today.
Today. That's impossible.
Well, politics is the art of impossible, which is why I'm taking lead on this important eco issue. I'm riding a bike everywhere from now on.
Huh?
I'm going to get my bicycle, my pollution-free vehicle. Ta-da!
Do you see what I have to deal with? But his shoe charger idea? Pretty cool.
So good.
Becky and Margo when we were 8 with our first purses. And love that purse. This is us when we were 9, when I showed them how to accessorize with boas. Every mayor needs a good boa. Am I boring you guys?
No, but you're boring me. Oh, takeout's ready.
Okay, purses and boas? Can't you come up with something better? You and Margo are the power behind the mayor, right? That's our angle.
Exactly. So we can surprise the WNT viewers with the behind-the-scenes expose. Dazzle them with our investigative brilliance.
Are you guys being sarcastic? Being the lead accessorizer to the mayor is hugely important.
Hey, I didn't know Margot had a bird.
She didn't.
But there's an empty bird cage in the...
This interview's over. Bye.
Bye.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I'm smelling an expose.
What are you doing, Mayor Richards?
I'm looking for that Spoke Hudson file. I want to review it.
Oh, Mayor Richards has a very unique filing system.
One of the many challenges of being mayor is keeping track of paperwork.
Sorry.
Why would Kiki lie to us? She did lie, right?
Oh, most definitely.
What do you think's going on?
I don't know, but we're about to find out.
Hey, guys. I just wanted to apologize for how I behaved earlier, just now.
How did you behave?
I don't know. I might have seemed all freaked out and stuff.
Really? Because we didn't feel that from you at all. You seemed perfectly normal.
Really? Because now I'm starting to feel a little uncomfortable.
Well, maybe that's because there's something that you want to tell us, Kiki.
Yes, Kiki, do you want to tell us something?
We're journalists, Kiki. We uncover the truth.
Yes, Kiki, the truth shall set you free.
I know what you're doing, guys. It's not gonna work. You're trying to make me admit to some sort of problem when there isn't.
You're telling us there's no funny business going on with that cage?
There's no story for us to pursue. Tell us, Kiki, and we'll walk away.
Guys, there's no story here. There's not some big conspiracy theory around the budgie cage.
That's funny, Kiki, because we never mentioned a budgie cage.
Did I say budgie cage? I meant bird cage. Okay. See ya.
need to talk to Becky or Margot, see if they can shed any light on this mystery.
Excuse me, gentlemen, do you have an appointment?
What? Since when do we need an appointment to see our friend?
Is, this because of the camera?
No.
We're tracking a very important case, and we need to access Becky now.
No.
Sam, do you believe in freedom of speech? Do you believe in democracy? Because Mo and I are journalists, and our job is to uncover the truth. Sam, there may be a conspiracy going on, and we would greatly, greatly appreciate your help.
Conspiracy?
Yes.
I will go and ask Mayor Rebecca for a special media pass.
Mayor Richards? Mayor Richards, we have a situation.
I know, I can't find the Spoke Hudson file.
No. This is a big problem. Mr. Hudson and his bike supporters are blockading traffic all over Mayfield.
Are you kidding me?
Do I kid?
Oh. There it is! Huh. I think this is past the point of paperwork.
I'll say.
This calls for action.
Good.
Hey, Sam, what can I do for you?
Yeah.
Oh, can you hang on a sec?
Yeah.
Hey, Geeks, what's going on?
Jarman and Mo are asking questions. About the budgie.
The budgie? You mean Vern?
Oh!
What did I say?
You surprised me.
Counselor Pugh, I'm so, so sorry.
My head. You know, there could be permanent brain damage.
Nothing that wasn't already there.
I'm sorry, Counselor Pugh, but you shouldn't have been riding your bike indoors.
Like you shouldn't be riding your skateboard indoors? Besides, I rang my bell loud and proud. If you had any respect for cyclists in general, you would have noticed that and paid attention. Could someone please answer those phones? Ringing is driving me crazy.
It's businesses all over Mayfield who are calling to complain because Spoke Hudson supporters are tying up traffic all over town.
Mayor Rebecca, we have your permission to issue a special media pass to Jarman and Mo.
What for?
I got this one, Bex. Sam, now's not the time to bother the mayor. The last thing she needs is more reporters snooping around. Hey, hi there.
Only you'd listen to Spoke Hudson and made just a few streets bike only.
Everyone out! You heard me. Out of my office, everyone!
But don't you want me to stay?
No, I need some time alone to think, okay?
Meltdown.
Out!
Hey, check this out, I just got something. I managed to find one of Margot's old online blogs. Apparently she had a budgie when she was a kid. A budgie that flew off.
That must have been devastating. I can't imagine how I'd feel if my bird flew off.
Dude, I just got a weird text.
Me too.
Meet me in the tugboat in the park in 15 minutes.
Bird brain.
Bird brain?
Safe to come in?
I heard about the door incident.
No, actually, I need a few more minutes alone, if you don't mind.
Just give me a call when you're ready. I'll be with Kiki.
All right.
Can you guys take a break, maybe?
No, it's all right. I promised him a full access interview, so if that means seeing the bad with the good, then so be it.
Is it hard being a teen mayor? You bet. People think it's easy being a politician, but when you're in the hot seat trying to please everybody all the time, that's when it gets hard. The pressure's enough to make even the best person crack.
I don't know, Mo. I'm getting a bad feeling in my gut.
Relax. Bird brain.
The rain
in Spain stays mainly in the plane.
Never put off till tomorrow what can be done today.
What? There is no fool like an old fool.
He who is everywhere is nowhere.
An apple a day keeps...
Okay, guys, enough. Hey, Sam, what are you doing here?
I have information.
About what?
About Mayor Rebecca and Kiki. Gentlemen, there is a conspiracy afoot.
Oh. Oh. Come on, Sam. Here. We're not done.
Nevertheless, they are covering up a nefarious secret about a budgie named Vern.
That's exactly what we're investigating. We believe that the budgie belonged to Margot. It went missing when she was a child. And if Becky and Kiki are trying to cover it up, that means...
They probably made it go missing. Ah, what?
So where did you get your intel?
I have my super secret security ways. I overheard Mayor Rebecca talk on the phone to Kiki.
Oh, this is so not good. I've got to get a grip on this situation.
Well, Mayor Richards, there you have it. Traffic in Mayfield is ground to a halt, all the citizens and business owners are furious, and it's becoming increasingly obvious to the WNT viewers that you do not have what it takes to handle a major crisis. Whereas someone with experience, like myself, can rise...
Fire, everybody.
Smoke.
Fire! Fire! Out of my way! Out of my way! Out of my way! Fire!
Okay, everyone, this is just like the drills we practice. Just stay calm, quickly get to your nearest exit, don't run, and close the doors behind you after you leave, please.
Good. Come on. Let's go. All right.
Close the doors behind you, guys. It's okay, Counselor Q. Just breathe. You'll be all right. Okay.
Where's Kiki and Margot?
What do you mean? They're still here?
They were waiting to talk to you after you had your little meltdown.
See? Told you. Mayor should not have meltdowns.
They were really concerned about you.
Where are they? Kiki! Marco!
Sorry, guys. My bad. Kiki thought you microwaved popcorn for 30 minutes.
I meant to push 3 minutes.
Fire! Fire!
What are you doing? What's wrong with him? Wow, it really smells like burnt popcorn in here.
Yeah, nice going, Keeks. As if Becky already didn't have enough on her plate, you had to go and add something else. Vern? That sounds just like my old budgie. Vern! Make it stop! Make it stop! Make the tripping stop!
Now, Kiki, calm down!
I can't do this anymore, Becky. I can't keep her secret. The truth about her dark past must come out.
And what dark past might that be?
Kiki, Becky, I think you owe Margo and the viewers of WNT an apology.
For what? Do you remember when we were kids and your budgie Vern flew away?
Yeah.
Well, it kind of sort of didn't.
Didn't fly away at all.
Huh?
I accidentally sat on him.
Budgie killer.
I'm sorry, Margo, but he flew right under my butt. And we didn't want you to know, so we just opened the cage and window and made it seem like he just escaped.
What did you do with Vern's body?
We buried him in the backyard.
But the story doesn't end there, ladies and gentlemen, because Vern wasn't dead. He was just knocked unconscious, and when he realized he was buried alive, he clawed his way to freedom.
How do you know Vern's still alive?
Because Vern is my budgie. You see, when a mud-covered bird landed in my backyard, I took it in, made it a part of my family. And it wasn't until moments ago that I realized it must have been Margot's.
All this time and you two have been lying to me?
Margot.
And I can't promise Mayfield streets are gonna be bike only, but I can promise a few new bike lanes. Okay, let's chat in a few days. Bye for now.
Spoke Hudson?
Yeah,
When I pointed out that his traffic blockade had delayed the fire department, he softened his position. I feel like such a bad person, Kiki.
Me too.
Margo!
Hey!
You shouldn't have lied.
I know. We really just didn't want to hurt your feelings.
And maybe Becky went about dealing with the situation the wrong... Okay, maybe we went about dealing with the situation the wrong way and only made it worse. I'm really sorry.
No, we feel terrible.
Okay. You guys are off the hook. But just promise never to keep any secrets like that from me again.
We promise.
Is that Fern?
Yes, except his name is Mr. Wigglebottom now.
Mr. Wigglebottom?
Mm-hmm.
Cute.
Oh, and I've decided you have visitation rights.
Really?
What a sweetie! Hi! Ow! You bit me!
Mm-hmm.
Well, you did accidentally bury him alive, Kiki.
I can't believe how nervous I am.
Oh, relax, you're gonna be great.
Really? You think a radical bike protest, a fire at City Hall, and Becky admitting she killed my budgie is gonna make her look great on TV?
See? I'm gonna look terrible.
Oh, it's on. Turn it up.
Might as well get it over with.
While we were shadowing the mayor yesterday, we got the opportunity to see her in action. She managed to evacuate City Hall during a fire alarm in record speed. Good job, Mayor Richards. And coming up next, an in-depth report on diamond doghouses, the newest wave of celebrity pet fashions.
What? That's not a documentary on me. That was barely even a news clip.
But at least you look good.
Diamond doghouses? We live in a sad, sad world.
Kiki, where are you going?
I'm gonna make some popcorn.
No!
It's your time to be yourself free, yourself free.
Became mayor. Oh, it's all happening in 2 days. Actually, what time is it?
11:52.
46 hours and 12 minutes, not even 2 full days. Oh, picture it. Shiny slides, swings, jungle gyms, sandboxes, flowers, shrubs. Oh, and then the centerpiece of the entire opening.
The burying of the time capsule.
You've mentioned it.
A couple dozen times.
Okay. I'm really excited. I mean, we spent weeks gathering the perfect stuff for the capsule, and I just can't wait! Life at this very moment is perfect. Nothing can wreck my mood right now. Hey, Misty, isn't it a wonderful day?
Mayor, City Hall's been shut down till further notice.
What? Why?
Mold.
Mold? How bad can mold be?
Bad.
Unless it's a good kind.
There's a good kind?
Where do you think penicillin comes from? Or blue cheese?
How do you know about blue cheese?
Margot told me.
I'm a wealth of information regarding all things moldy.
Anyway, there's no point in you coming in today, Mayor Richards.
What? No, I still have tons of paperwork to do with the park opening, and I have to organize everything for the capsule. How am I supposed to get all that done without an office?
I know that it's a major inconvenience, but we may have to postpone the opening.
No, not an option. Those kids have waited long enough. I can't keep them waiting anymore. I keep my promises.
I understand. I'm in the process of arranging alternate workspace for us, so if all goes well, we may be able to proceed as planned. All right.
Okay.
I'll keep you posted. Bye.
Bring it on, you know I got what it
indirect, son, Mayor Richards.
Good. Poor thing, still traumatized by the move.
I can't believe you brought your ficus with you, Mrs. D.
Joe, I love that plant almost as much as I love Mr. DeMarco. Sometimes more. Where I go, it goes.
Oh! What is it? It's a bug. Oh my gosh, it's a bug. Ew, what kind of bug is it? Tell me what kind of bug it is.
What is it? I was wondering where this was. I can't tell you how many times I've looked for it. Never thought I'd see it again.
What is it?
My medallion. From the Mayfield Centennial over 50 years ago. Everyone who worked at City Hall got one.
You've worked here for over 50 years? You are well preserved, Mrs. D.
Not me. Mrs. Studebaker, who trained me, gave it to me before she left. And talk about well-preserved. I think that she started as Lord Mayfield's assistant. She said this would bring me luck. And it has, even though it's been tucked in my drawer for all these years.
What?
I'd like you to have it.
No. I can't take your medallion.
Of course you can.
But you just found it after all this time. Aren't you gonna miss it?
No. I'll know where it is.
Really?
Really.
Thank you, Mrs. D.
Okay. Here you go.
Oh, I love it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
What you doing?
It'll be a fun shot for the time capsule. Show everyone in 100 years what a messy eater the mayor was.
Thank you. Where's the box full of the time capsule stuff?
Oh. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. You're not an uh-oh type of person, so when you say uh-oh, it can't be good.
The movers must have left it behind.
Well, we have to go back and get it.
It's not possible. City Hall is being fumigated. It's locked up, cordoned off. No one comes in, no one goes out, except for the mold guys in the hazmat suits.
Well, can't one of them just bring it out?
How? The capsule contents are in cardboard boxes, just like all the other cardboard boxes at City Hall right now. There's no way they're going to find it.
Aw, man. The capsule's the main event of the opening. What are we supposed to do, bury an empty box?
Ooh, we'll figure something out. All we have to do is put our heads together and come up with another idea. It'll be fine.
Kiki, do you have to keep taking pictures?
I'm documenting you. And this will probably be the only thing you're putting in your time capsule.
Kiki, that's it! You're a genius!
I know! Wait, do you mind telling me why?
We're gonna set up an electronic time capsule. We'll put up a video camera and invite the citizens of Mayfield to come in and give their good wishes and thoughts to the Mayfieldians to come.
Then put it on DVD and bury that.
Yeah, it'll be perfect for the opening. The park is for the kids, and the DVD will be for the kids' kids. And then we're gonna edit it onto DVDs. What do you think?
Oh, Mayor Rebecca, words cannot adequately describe how beside myself I am about this magnificent idea. And I am so honored that you would ask me to do this. I must swear an oath.
No, you don't have to do that.
No, I do. I really do.
Okay.
I vow to make everyone look the best so that future generations will be so impressed with how neat and well-lit our citizens are.
Awesome.
Hi there, future Mayfieldians. I wonder what you guys are all wearing right now. But just so you know, a couple of tips. Leg warmers only look good on dancers. I cannot stress this enough. And sweatpants should never, ever be worn outside the gym. And lilac as a color on any clothing should be against the law by the time you people get this. Bye for now.
This is the perfect spot to bury the time capsule.
Really? I don't think it's parky enough. I want it to be near the slides and the swings and...
No, it has to be here. Listen.
You gave a Maggie baggie. You gave a Maggie baggie. You gave a Maggie baggie. You gave a Maggie baggie baggie.
All right, all right. I get it.
What is it?
A song. We wrote it for you, for the opening. We want to immortalize you.
Okay. Thanks, I guess.
Thing is, the acoustics by the slides and the swings and all that parky stuff, brutal. In this exact spot, however,
thing of beauty.
Do you hear how the sound bounces perfectly off this elm tree?
Not really.
It's a maple.
No, it's elm. Try again.
Yeah, but it is a maple.
The elm.
Whatever, it's a tree.
Either way, we need good acoustics.
Margot is filming our performance.
And we want it to go viral.
One, two, three.
Oh, you're just a tad shiny. Let me fix it for you. Go. You what? Go shower and brush your teeth. Do you want people in the future to think that we had dismal dental hygiene and never washed our hair? I don't need to be such a bully.
Hi. So, you're here.
The future.
Wow. Okay, seriously? Is there a future? I mean, come on. How's the air? Don't you only like gas masks by now or something? And that's only if the ozone layer's still around and you haven't all been burned to a crisp. Oh, and I'd love to see animal life 100 years from now. We've been having all sorts of two-headed pigs and lambs, and cows, and frogs. Oops. I was trying to be upbeat. Ah, I can't do this.
How do I look? A little more flair wouldn't have killed you.
Kiki, we're not going to the red carpet. We're going to a park and burying a capsule.
Still, hair product? Not the enemy, Becky.
Shoo! I'm fine. And we have to go.
Becky.
Excellent. All right, look at the camera and say brie.
Why not cheese?
It's a less forced, more natural smile. Cheese. Brie.
Oh. Brie!
Excellent.
Yay!
For luck.
Those kids, weren't they adorable?
The opening was amazing. You did good.
Oh, it just went the way it was supposed to.
For some of us.
I uploaded the photos onto my computer. Check it out.
Oh, mission accomplished. We have our part.
See, the tree acoustics are all wrong. If only you had listened.
If only you had practiced.
You were great. Something wrong with people's ears.
My medallion. It's gone.
Bonus!
You found it!
No, but I found a really cool silver dollar.
Not bad, man.
We're cleaning up. So far, we have enough for
a medium pizza and a couple of large shakes.
Sweet.
Becky, check this out.
Not the Hecky Becky song again.
So you definitely had it when you left for the opening. And here you are about to bury the time capsule.
And it's gone.
Yeah.
Which means I lost it at the park. This is a disaster. I'm never gonna find it there. I'm gonna go look for it. Okay, so, you know what I said? I'm gonna go look for it. What I meant was, let's all go look for it. Huh?
Becky, I say we secure the perimeter and do a grid search while you're at work.
Yes.
Are you feeling all right, Mayor Richards?
Sure. Why?
Well, it's such a nice, warm spring day, and the air conditioning in the building hasn't been turned on yet. Don't you feel kind of warm in that scarf and that hoodie?
I have this crazy reptilian body temperature thing, always cold.
Oh.
It's crazy. Yeah. Hello?
Hey, it's me. Nothing yet.
Really? How interesting.
What?
Mrs. D.
Would you find the
latest cat neutering report? I just have to check something on it really quickly.
Oh, Mrs. D's beside you.
Uh-huh. Almost. Isn't that amazing?
Sure. Okay. I'll keep you posted.
That's great. Okay. Wish her a happy birthday for me, too.
Okay.
Just give me that.
Happy birthday, Keeks.
Huh?
Nothing.
I'm out of ideas. I had the medallion. We went to the park. I no longer have the medallion.
Maybe someone found it before we got there.
Oh.
Or
what?
Maybe it fell off your neck into the time capsule box.
Of course! That's brilliant! Okay, so you know what I said? Of course, that's brilliant! What I meant was, let's all go to the park and dig up the time capsule.
It's getting late. My mom will kill me if I come home covered in dirt at who knows what time tonight.
Yeah, you're right. I'm sorry.
Gross.
But tomorrow's not a work day, so we can wake up super early and go down there before anyone else gets there. What?
You and super early don't go together.
Mm-mm. Okay, guys, I'm not that bad.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah. No, I'm not.
Sorry, Beth.
Pretty bad.
Can't take any more of this.
I am hurrying.
How can you stand it?
Oh, I've put myself into a meditative state. I've slowed my heart rate down, and I'm wearing earplugs.
Got it.
Finally.
It's not in here!
What do you mean it's not in there? It has to be in here.
Well, it's not.
Oh, my life is over.
Got blisters on my fingers from jamming. Lucky the action on my axe is smooth.
If by axe you mean musical instrument, then you have to stop talking like that.
But that's how real musicians talk.
My point exactly.
It's bad. She's off her food.
Why don't you just tell Mrs. D the truth? I mean, it's not like you lost it on purpose.
Bad idea. Mrs. D will never forgive her because Becky broke her heart. Do you want to be responsible for that? Didn't think so.
Sorry.
What about getting a new one?
You can't get a new one. They're from the Mayfield Centennial over 50 years ago.
So, my uncle's a jeweler. Give me a picture and he can make a new one.
Oh, I have a shot on my computer.
That's great. Why didn't you mention this before?
Didn't really think about it. Huh? Too busy focusing on the music.
Oh, we're moving back to City Hall. Fumigation's complete.
Oh, that's great.
Do you mind if I ask you, Mayor Richards, where did you get that?
Well, this? Well, you gave it to me.
No, I don't think so. No. This is the one I gave you.
Well, that's impossible. There's probably two.
No. This is definitely the one I gave you. I would recognize this scratch anywhere.
Okay. Here's what happened. And so we got Mo's uncle, who's a jeweler, to make a copy for us.
I don't believe it. You did all of that for nothing. If you would have told me, I would have given it back.
Where'd you find it? We looked everywhere.
In the ficus.
Oh, yeah, I was over there before the opening. I was rubbing it for good luck.
Well, you rubbed it so hard that the chain broke. I found it Monday morning. Why didn't you tell me the truth?
Well, I didn't want to hurt you.
Do I look that delicate?
I'm glad you find it so funny. Do you know how much trouble we went through?
Well, I am sorry, Mayor Richards, but I have to say, you deserved it.
What?
Mm-hmm. You should have told me the truth right off the top. By worrying about how hurt I'd be, you lied to me, and that hurts more.
I'm really sorry, Mrs. D. I never wanted to hurt you.
Well, don't worry about it. I'm getting over it already. You dug up the time capsule, huh? I would love to see that.
All right. Laugh it up. Laugh it up.
By the time you see this, the future will be the present. And guess what? I plan to be around to see it with you.
Okay, so I'll have a few gray hairs, but I'll still be hanging out. And Margs and Kiki, they'll be hanging out too.
I wonder how many teenage mayors there'll be between now and then. A lot, I hope. Because you know, we have some really good ideas. Like this one, for example.
That was great. Thank you for making me a copy of the DVD. Woo! I'm having one of my brilliant ideas. Mayfield, that means you, should make a ton of them and hand them out to all the Mayfieldians who want a copy.
Amazing, that actually is brilliant.
Ooh, and then we can use it as a souvenir of my time in office.
Yeah, that too.
I can't wait to get back to City Hall.
By the time you're watching this, you will already know who we are. Because we're cultural icons. You will know our names. Unless we have them changed.
You will know our faces.
Unless we have work done to maintain our boyish good looks.
But most importantly,
you'll know us for our music.
Unless we get famous for something else.
Like what?
I don't know. Probably the music.
Yeah, definitely.
Definitely the music.
Yeah. Oh, Becky, chilling in a park with Darman. Just singing about Becky. Becky Richards is the mayor, even though she's a teenager. Isn't that inspiring? You're not.